How many time zones are there? I'm based in the United States, so I tend to think of our four default time zones, Eastern, Central, Mountain, Pacific. But I also know that Arizona doesn't follow daylight savings time. And even stranger, the Navajo Nation, which is within Arizona, does follow daylight savings time. So we're quickly up to six time zones already. And I think we all know it's much worse than that. So let's look at the PHP documentation for time zones. We'll take a look at North and South America because it's the longest list and there are some oddities here. So first off, there are a lot of time zones here. And there are some weird ones like Argentina here. Argentina has 12 time zones for some reason. One country, they get their own Argentina prefix. And it's not a huge country. It's a tall country, not a wide country. So I think they should only have one or two time zones. But they have 12. And then you see things like America / Indiana for some reason. Indiana has 8 time zones. And only one of them is a city I recognize. North Dakota has 3. That's a time zone for every person in North Dakota. So how do we end up with these unusual time zone definitions? I got curious about it. I went digging and I'm going to bring you with. In PHP, our time zone definitions come from a C library called TimeLib, and it's maintained by Derek Reffins. He's one of the core PHP maintainers. But he's not inventing these. They come from the time zone database, which is maintained by the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority, which sounds interesting enough, but we're going to keep moving to the TZ Git repo. And this is where I hit gold. This is a beautiful Git repo. This is not just the definitions of what the time zones are, but it is the history of why time zones are the way they are. And it's well documented. You can see Indiana has its own section here. Apparently, a number of Indiana counties just have always done their own thing with time. And so this is how you end up with 8 different Indiana time zones in our time definition. And I just want to call out this little story from Arthur David Olson back in 2011, surely an unpaid open source maintainer, making phone calls to get to the bottom of this. Quote, I just spoke by phone with a staff member at the Metlakatla Indian Community Office. It's shortly after 1 o'clock here on the East Coast of the United States. The staffer said it was shortly after 10 o'clock there. When I asked whether that meant they were on Pacific time, they said no, they were on their own time, another time zone. I asked about daylight saving. They said it wasn't used. So here we have this open source maintainer figuring things out, dealing with the mess of time zones around the world. And then it all gets packaged up and wrapped in dependencies, and we get to use it. So we get to use all this hard-won knowledge in our applications, and we don't have to worry about it. So let's talk about our own applications. The first lesson is use that knowledge. If there was ever a time to use someone else's code, this is it. Please do not invent your own time zone handling support. And in Laravel, that means that we're working with a package called Carbon, which can do a lot of things with dates and times, can do comparisons and math, convert between formats, and it can handle time zones. So we'll talk about that. But first, we're going to talk about UTC. And I want to call out Laravel's default configuration. By default, Laravel uses UTC, and this is perfect. You should not change this setting. This means that anytime you're asking Laravel, give me a Carbon object, it will give you a Carbon object in UTC. It also means whenever you create a model or update a model, the timestamps in your database will be in UTC, which is great. You don't want it in a different time zone, even if it's tempting to make it convenient for you. You don't want it in a different time zone because it's unpredictable. You don't know if it was daylight savings time. You don't know when the laws changed. You don't know if someone changed the time zone. So stick with UTC. And then step up from that is defining an application time zone. And I like to do this with my own custom config value. I just pull in whatever time zone makes the most sense for me if it's a small project, for my users if it's a larger project. And I'm going to use this anytime I need to display a time to my users. And we'll do that with a cool trick here. In App Service Provider, you can register macros. And many things in Laravel are macroable. For example, Blade is macroable. You can create custom Blade directives. You can do custom, you can macro Eloquent, and you can do Carbon, among others. And what a macro is it's just a convenience method that you can use on any Carbon object. So here I have in application time zone. I'll show you how you use it, but I just define it as a simple closure. It just runs the TZ method, which is carbon's change to this time zone method, and it grabs that config value that we just set. So this means if we hop over to Tinkerwell, when we call now, we get the current time in UTC. If we call TZ on that, then we'll get that time in that time zone. But now we can just replace this straight up with in application time zone. And we get the same effect. So now we're getting a carbon object in that one configured value. And we can use this throughout our application. No need to reference config, no hard-coded time zones anywhere. It's all centrally located in one spot and it reads very fluently. So this is all thanks to that macro. And then you still have a carbon object, so you can just tack on more methods. You can do whatever you want. And this works with any date, any carbon object that you're getting. For example, your user model timestamps, these are just carbon objects. So instead of manually converting them, you just do your in application time zone and away you go. So this is a beautiful way to just clean up your application code and make it very understandable. This particular date or time object is going to be in this particular time format. The next step up from that would be to define a user time zone. And then you can do the same trick with a macro. I've got it registered as in user time zone here. And here we're just looking at the logged in user, if they exist, and if they have a time zone set, we'll use it. If not, we fall back to the config value for a default. So this works the exact same way. Hop back into Tinkerwell here. First, we'll have to log in as a user. Don't do this in production. But this logs in as a user to populate auth user. And now we have in user time zone and we can do whatever we want to it. So anytime you're displaying timestamps in your application, you can do this in a user dependent way. So let's talk about how you associate a time zone with a user. The first thing you can try is guessing their time zone based on their IP address. There's a community package called Laravel Time Zone, and you can give this a try to get close to their time zone, maybe exactly in their time zone. And if you're using JavaScript on the front end, you do have access to their time zone from the browser, and you can transform dates in the front end. But if you want to have an exact time zone specified for that user, it might be useful for running reports or accurate timestamps in your application, you can prompt them to provide it. And I wanted to show you a fun approach to that using a built-in library class. So here's a quick Laravel LiveWire component that I wrapped up here. I have a select box with every country in the world. And then I have a time zone picker below that LiveWire is filling in for me. And it's only showing those from the United States. And that's a fun little trick that the standard library gives us. So let's take a look at how I did that. We'll see that when I save it, it updates my user model and we'll hop into that little LiveWire component. It is depending on this date time zone list identifiers. And you can call this and you can either pass in a two-digit country code like US or DE, or you can pass in a region, and I'll show you how that works. This is the country code method, and it returns an array, in this case of all the Canadian time zones, turns out they have a lot. And here, it will give me all the European time zones. So if you're in a situation where you need to list out time zones and you need to parse through, break them down by some group, this is a fun way to do it. And this is just in the standard library. Love to find tools like that for us. So to recap, the first thing is use that hard-fought open source knowledge, use other people's code when you're working with time zones. The second thing is make sure you're storing in UTC and don't change from that. The third is use these fun carbon macros to make sure that you can wrap up that logic and put it in one place in your application. And the last thing is take a peek at date time zone. It's kind of fun. So I'm Ben Holman. Thanks for spending your time with me.